A ping problem here and PCB cannot ping PCA. What can be the reason here? Let's go through choices one by one. Incorrect subnet mask on PCB. Incorrect default gateway on PCB. Incorrect subnet mask on PCA. Incorrect default gateway on PCA. Incorrect IP address on PCA. What do you think? What is the reason of this ping failure? Let's go through choices one by one and find the correct answer. Incorrect subnet mask on PCB. So let's check PCB subnet mask 255.255.255.0 and here /24. Yes, it is correct subnet mask. And incorrect default gateway on PCB. Let's check the default gateway of PCB 192.168.1.1. Oh, here, yes, this is our answer. It must be .2.1 because the interface IP address of router 2 is 192.168.2.1. So this is our answer. And let's also go to the other choices. Subnet mask on PCA is also correct. Default gateway of PCA is also correct. The default gateway of PCA is the interface IP address of this router. One interface and incorrect IP address on PCA. Yes, it is correct IP address. It is an IP address in the same network with this interface. So for this question, our answer is B. Which user password is configured with these Cisco commands? Here are the choices. SSH, Telnet, Auxiliary, Console, or none of them. What do you think? The answer of this question is console connection. Here we are configuring the user console password. How many broadcast and collision domains on this local area network? Here we have one router, 4 switches and 2 servers connected to these switches. What do you think? How many broadcast and collision domains on this local area network? Let's firstly start with broadcast domains again. And here we have one router. So each router interface is one broadcast domain. When we count the interfaces of the router, we will find the broadcast domain number. One switch is also one broadcast domain by default. When one switch is connected to one router interface, then we will count it as one broadcast domain. For this question, we have 4 broadcast domains. How about collision domains? All these broadcast domains are also one collision domain, but we will also add 2 collision domains because of the other interfaces of switches. Each switch interface is one collision domain, and here 2 switches are also connected to servers. Each of these interfaces are also one collision domain. There are 4 router interfaces connected to the switches. These are 4 collision domains, and there are 2 interfaces connected to the servers from the switches. These are also collision domains. Totally, we have 4 plus 2, 6 collision domains. For this question, our answer is 4 broadcast domains and 6 collision domains. Which next hop should we use on router 1 static route towards the destination network 10.0.0.0/24? For a static route, we should write firstly destination network, destination subnet mask, and then next hop interface IP address. So for router 1, to reach the destination network, our next hop will be the interface of router 2, and the IP address of this interface is 192.168.0.2. So our answer is B for this question. A drag and drop question about BGP components and their definitions. Here I will give you some BGP components and I will give you some descriptions, and you will match these components to descriptions. BGP speakers, IBGP peer, EBGP peer, AS number and prefix. So these descriptions are neighbor that share the same AS number as a local device, value that is advertised with network keyword, neighbor that located outside of AS domain of the local device, device that runs BGP. What is the correct match for you? So let's go and match these definitions to these components. BGP speaker, device that run BGP. IBGP peer, neighbor that share the same AS number as a local device. EBGP peer, neighbor that's located outside of AS domain of the local device. AS number, value that identify an AS. prefix value that is advertised with network keyword. How many broadcast and collision domains on this local area network? Here we have two routers, three switches, and four different host devices, servers or PCs. Here, let's first start with broadcast domains. As we have explained before, each router interface is one broadcast domain and each switch is one broadcast domain by default. Here, to find the broadcast domains, we will count the number of router interfaces. When we count router interfaces, we have four router interfaces, so our broadcast domain number is 4. How about collision domains? Each router interface and switch interface is one collision domain, so here we will count the interfaces between routers and switch and between switches and the host devices. When we count these interfaces, we will find the number of 8. We have 8 collision domains. Our answer for this question is 4 broadcast domains and 8 collision domains. Here is an ERGRP IP version 6 configuration steps question. We give IP version 6 ERGRP steps to you and you will order these steps one by one. According to you, what is the correct order? Let me tell you, IP version 6 ERGRP, ASI number, enable configure terminal, router ID, IP version 6 router EIGRP AS number. What is the correct order? The correct order is firstly using enable command and then configure terminal and then IP version 6 router EIGRP with AS number and then using router ID or setting router ID and then IP version 6 EIGRP AS number configuration command. So our answer is D. Which ones are related with UDP, User Datagram Protocol? Let's see the choices. Sends transmission in sequence. Transmits packets individually. Transmission includes an 8-byte header. Uses lower transmission rate to ensure reliability. Transmits packet as stream. Higher transmission rate for latency sensitive applications. Which ones are related with UDP? Not TCP, but UDP. Let's go to choices one by one. Sends transmission in sequence. Yes, this is the property of TCP. Transmits packets individually. This is true for UDP. Transmission includes an 8-byte header. Yes, UDP header is 8-byte. Uses lower transmission rate to ensure reliability. Not true. Transmits packet as stream. Not true. Higher transmission rates for latency-sensitive applications. Yes, this is also true. So our answers are 2, 3, and 6. Let's remember again. Transmission packets individually. Transmission include an 8-byte header and higher transmission rate for latency sensitive applications. Here is another drag and drop question about cloud services and their descriptions. Let's see the options. SaaS, PaaS, and IaaS. Now I'm reading the descriptions. Web streaming application development. Examples, Windows Azure, Google Application Engine. Hardware, networks, servers, operating systems. Examples, Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud Storage. End user interface, user customization. Examples, Gmail, Facebook, LinkedIn. What is the correct match? Let's see the answers. SaaS, end user interface, user customization. Gmail, Facebook, and LinkedIn are examples. PaaS, web streaming application development, and examples are Windows Azure, Google Application Engine. IaaS, hardware, networks, servers, operating systems. Amazon Web Services and Google Cloud Storage are examples. Another static route question, and here I'm asking that which next hop should be used on router 2 to reach the destination network. Here, our destination network is 172.16.0.0/16 network. And here, on router 2, we need to write a static route to reach this destination network. So, our question is, what is the next hop? Let's remember how we write static routes. Firstly, for a static route, we write the destination network and the destination subnet mask. And then we write the next hop to reach this destination network. For router 2, to reach this destination network, our next hop must be 20.20.20.2. Our answer for this question is D.